Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. Before we begin the Mass, I request all of you to recall to mind all your intentions that you have for this Mass. I offer this Eucharist for the intentions of the family of Mrs. and Mr. George, who have made this pilgrimage for us, who have arranged this pilgrimage for us. Today we celebrate the memorial of St. Paul Mickey and his companions who were martyred, that we shall pray that through the intercession of these saints, we too may have strong faith and courage, even to sacrifice our life for the cause of our faith. In a special way, we shall pray to our Blessed Mother in this holy place, that she will help us and assist us in all our struggles against the evil forces of this world, to become day by day holy people. With these intentions, let us begin our Eucharist. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, to celebrate worthily this Eucharist, let us call to mind all our shortcomings and ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, strength of all the saints who through the cross were pleased to call the martyrs St. Paul Mickey and companions to life, grant, we pray, that by their intercession we may hold with courage even until death to the faith that we profess. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Our reading from the letter to the Hebrews. In the fight against sin, you have not yet heart to keep fighting to the point of death. Have you forgotten that encouraging text in which you are addressed as sons? My son, when the Lord corrects you, do not treat it lightly, but do not get discouraged when he reprimands you. For the Lord trains the ones that he loves, and he punishes all those that he acknowledges as his son. Suffering is part of your training. God is treating you as his sons. Has there ever been any son whose father did not train him? Of course, any punishment is most painful at the time and far from pleasant, but later, in those on whom it has been used, it bears fruit in peace and goodness. So hold up your lip, arms, and steady your trembling knees, and smooth out the path you tread. Then the injured limb will not be wrenched. It will grow strong again. Always be wanting peace with all people, and the holiness without which no one can ever see the Lord. Be careful that no one is deprived of the grace of God, and no root of bitterness should begin to grow and make trouble. This can poison a whole community. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. Your response, the love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. My soul, give thanks to the Lord. All my being, bless his holy name. My soul, give thanks to the Lord and never forget all his blessings. Your response, the love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. As a father has compassion on his sons, the Lord has pity on those who fear him. For he knows of what we are made. He remembers that we are dust. Your response, the love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. But the love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. His justice reaches out to children's children when they keep his covenant in truth. Your response, the love of the Lord is everlasting upon those who hold him in fear. Alleluia, alleluia. Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went to his town and his disciples accompanied him. With the coming of the Sabbath, he began teaching in the synagogue, and most of them were astonished when they heard him. They said, "Where did the men get all this? What is this wisdom that has been granted him, and these miracles that are worked through him? This is the carpenter, surely the son of Mary, the brothers of James and John and Jude and Simon. His sisters too, are they not here with us?" And they would not accept him. And Jesus said to them, "A prophet is only despised in his own country, among his own relations, and in his own house. And he could work no miracles there, though he cured a few sick people by laying his hands on them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus. Dear friends in Christ Jesus, I would like to share with you a small incident that happened in my life. I joined in the seminary in the year 1997 on the 13th day of June. I entered in the seminary. After 2 years of my seminary studies, one day I was suddenly sick. It was at night, around 10:30, I went to the chapel, and 10 or 15 minutes I might have in the chapel, and I went to the bed. But when I lie down on the bed, suddenly my body started jerking. I could not lie down. My head was simply shaking like this. Suddenly I called one of my friends and told him. He went and informed the rector. Rector came and he asked me to lie down and show me. I showed, he got frightened. Because the whole body was jerking like anything. I think he might have thought it may be some evil possession or something like that, or some unknown sickness. Suddenly, he rang up to the doctor in our own hospital. Doctor was ready. She was a sister. Went there, checked. She told, "I have not seen this kind of sickness." Then next day, I was taken to different doctors. I think in that city, around 10, 15 doctors were consulted. The sickness was new for them, and I was made unconscious. I was taken to a medical college, some 500 kilometers away from that city. I was there 3-4 days in a state of unconsciousness, and the rector was with me when I got consciousness, he gave me a book to praise the Lord, praising all the creation, praising the trees, praising the trees praising the Lord, or all creation praising the Lord. Then I have a sister who is a nun. She replaced the rector, and we were praying. I thought I lost my vocation. Then came her provincial and some sisters. This is what exactly happened there. We recited, we prayed the whole rosary, the 150 Hail Marys in those days. We prayed, and they left for meeting the hospital sisters. And I was alone in the room where I was sitting, and I prayed really to our Blessed Mother after saying the rosary. And it was told in my mind, I am healed. I am healed. If you have doubt, you lie down and see. And I lie down, and I found it was no more jerking without any medicine. It was the power of the rosary. It was the intervention of our Blessed Mother in my life. Then I went, there was a statue of our Blessed Mother. I knelt down there, I prayed, and suddenly I went to the nurse's room, where usually a doctor also there. There I went and I told Sister Mercy, Sister, I am healed. I have no more problem. But I was a bit afraid they may think that I am psychologically in disorder. So suddenly I lie down on a pew and showed them, see, I am no problem. So they were all surprised. I told, I prayed to Mother. After the rosary, I am healed. And it was a great joy for me in my life. And this is what the Mother who did in my life. Yes, today we heard how Jesus was rejected by his own people. Sometimes we too may face with these tragedies, these problems in our lives. Sometimes our own family members, sometimes when you become older and older, your own children may reject you. Sometimes your own friends, relatives, you may face this rejection and criticism. But you can depend upon a person, that is our Blessed Mother, who will always hear our cry, who will always there to give us strength, support. She is a person who has undergone all these sufferings, all these hardships who faced. And she had the courage because she was very close to the Lord. So too, she will take us very close to the Lord. Today, as we celebrate this Eucharist, let us keep this in mind and celebrate this Eucharist with this faith. And the Lord, through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, will bless all of us who are here. Thank you. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we are received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased to sacrifice. We offer you the humble and contrite hearts. Lord, what will you do for my sins? Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Let us pray. Receive, Holy Father, the offerings we bring in commemoration of the holy martyrs, and grant that we, your servants, may be found steadfast in confessing your name, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We will lift up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we proclaim your death, O Lord, and promise your resurrection until you come again, therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, our church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of the charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and our bishops, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. I especially pray for the family of Mr. and Mrs. George, and all of you are gathered here participating in this Eucharist. Welcome them into the light, and with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, especially Saint Paul Mickey and the companions whose memory we celebrate today, who are pleased to you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, All glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Them the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. O God, who in your holy martyrs have wonderfully made known the mysteries of the cross, graciously grant that drawing strength from this sacrifice, we may cling faithfully to Christ and labor in the church for the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Once again, I thank all of you who have participated in this Eucharist. I have firm faith that our Blessed Mother will take all our intentions to the Lord and will grant us all that we need. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.